Good afternoon. We are now ready to start with our second session of interviews from our open house. I'm really glad to be here with Matteo Gattola, which is the founder and CTO of Envision. Hi Matteo, I saw you were busy in another panel just a few minutes before this interview, and I could listen that you anticipate some of the themes we are going to deal with in this interview. And I really appreciate a sentence I was hearing, and it was the city constructing the city we deserve. So that's why I would like to ask to you, how do you see the transformation of cities in this post-pandemic era?
Thank you. But the city, as we discussed before during the panel, we say that the cities and the communities now are developing new waves to respond to the pandemic. But probably it's important to define a new concept of the cities, a city with different approach, and we think that the future of the cities must be redesigned with a citizen-centric approach. Someone before discussed about the resilient city, but we normally use resilient word as a synonymous of climate change adaptation. In the reality, when we discuss about a resilient city, we must think a city that absorb and recover shock and stress, and while maintaining its essential functionality. For this reason, now the transformation is not so easy. It's a complex process, because the transformation of a city means to define, to use the technology, to spread the technology in the territory, but are key challenge, very, very complex to address and to exceed. The first probably is that when you discuss about or you want to realize a smart cities, it's important to consider that you have a different system that you must manage, the interoperability between the system. It's necessary to think also that new skills, professional skill will be able to provide the service. But not only, we have several regulations that we must guarantee according to the compliance. But last but not least, we have several stakeholders that on the table, the same table, must take the decision by have conflicting interest. And so for this reason, they became always difficult to address the final solution. So in this scenario, there are some positive opportunities, you know, because the first one is that now in the vision have on this concrete application, it's possible to update the urban infrastructure to guarantee the spread of the sensor of the sensor on the territory, because the first issue of a smart city is to generate the data, to collect the data, but to have the data it's important to have sensors spread on the territory. So for us it's important to address the urban infrastructure, light street lamps, traffic lights, network, bus stop, and all these elements is important to transform in digital, in smart, and we are able to do, to manage the data collected with Urban Vision, our platform that we can see. Ecco, in this moment we see on Roma the Our complete application is a trial in Rome that it's possible, which it's possible to collect the data, to provide services to the citizen, to guarantee the pedestrian safety, the transportation, public transportation, managing the data, and so on. Many applications, concrete applications for a smart city that now it's not only a discussion in theory, but it's possible to realize.
So thank you for your informations. And what you have just said is in a certain way related to the Rome trial project, so you already mentioned about it. Yeah. And I would like to ask you, how was this experience? How was the experience of being the context? So to put the technology you work for in the context, in the real city.
But was been an interest experience with Sony. We have had, we have used for first, I think, in the world, the IMX500 imaging sensor with AI functionality, and a very, very important product, an intelligent sensor with many capabilities that we have integrated in our smart pole and smart bus stop, and now we are able to provide services very innovative, probably unique in the world. The smart parking, that it's possible to analyze in real time the free parking in the cities, the number of passengers in the public transportation in real time. So the real means of this experience is that when you manage in real time the data, it's possible to provide real services to the citizen. And in this occasion, this experience was very interesting for us, using the imaging, the IMX500 imaging sensor of Sony, because it's possible to realize the processing directly on board into the pole, into the smart bus stop, and so we realize the processing that normally is collected is considered edge computing, and so it's important because you make the analysis, you make the processing of the data directly in the product.
Thank you. And what about the contribution Envision is giving for this event, on occasion of this event?
But this is an important occasion because Make a Fair, it's important in Europe and the world. And for us, it's an important occasion to show our solutions. We have collected many interests from the visitors and the people that are in this stand. This is an important stand, the Sony stand, with many other applications, very, very innovative and very interesting. We have collected many interests on our solution because it's possible with the solution of Envision to realize a unique smart infrastructure on the urban territory that collects the data with a unique command control platform that is our Urban Vision platform that is in this moment on monitor in the that you can see. And we have also business model that consolidated that we can share with our customer, local administration or corporate that are interested to realize a smart infrastructure.
Thank you. So thank you, Matteo. I know that we are going to talk also later. So yeah, we will have a second interview and we will face more properly the topic of infrastructure and business model. So yeah, we will see later. And so thank you for this interview. We have it's all, and we will wait for you for the next one.
Thank you. See you.